to all of you. Hope you are all doing well. We are coming to the last class of our GIS OHD series, but don't worry, this is not the last class, it's only the last for the time being on YouTube. We will be having a lot of special classes which also you can come for on the platform. If you have any doubts, if you are replying to the answers, please reply to them in the chat box. I can see your messages in the YouTube chat. And please maintain discipline on the chat box and try to respond promptly so we can cover as many questions as I have lined up for you today. Alright. Okay. So as people are joining in, for those coming to the platform for the first time, let me tell you a little bit about me and about our platform. So I am Dr. Amrit Nasta. I am a bariatric surgeon from Mumbai and I am your surgery educator on the Unacademy platform. Please download the Unacademy learning app where you can follow my profile, where you will get regular updates about my upcoming classes. I will be taking a lot of special classes from this weekend onwards till the rest of March, covering a lot of important concepts, high yield topics in surgery. Apart from me, you can see there are a lot of educators, each will help you for different subjects for your entrance exams, whether it's NEET PG, whether it's INI CET, whether it's FMG. If you wish to learn from us, definitely you should subscribe to the Plus platform. On the Plus platform, you will get access to a lot of classes, a lot of batch courses. Now, these batch courses have educators who will cover all subjects in a short amount of time, and it's going to be very exam specific. So there is a batch course which started this month for NEET 2021. Then there are longer duration batch courses for next 2022, FMG exams, and so on. If you do wish to subscribe, this is the code to use, 10surgery. This code will get you a 10% discount in whatever subscription plan you take. Apart from that, there are a lot of free sessions, free videos, like I take a lot of YouTube videos. This month I've taken many. There are some more coming up in the next few days, as well as the special classes. I will be posting about the special classes on Telegram and you can get them on my profile. So definitely follow me, follow my profile. And there are a lot of free test series. The grand test series is what you should definitely go for. It's absolutely free of charge. It's like a mock exam to help you understand how far away you are from the exam, which is 1 month away. Exactly 1 month to go. It's now time to up your game and practice as much as you can. Right. So there are two kinds of subscriptions you can take with us. There is a Plus subscription and there is an Iconic subscription. Plus subscription, you get live classes, you get batch courses like I was telling you about, as well as a structured schedule. Iconic, you get benefits of Plus. Also, you get benefits of PrepLadder. Iconic subscription, minimum duration is 1 year. So this you should only go for if you are appearing for exams next year, not this year, because this is minimum 1 year. This has pre-recorded lectures for all subjects, all the topics, a huge nice question bank, handwritten notes, many things to help you with your preparation. So whatever exam you are targeting, think about a subscription plan of that liking, a 12 month or an 18 month if you are targeting next year. This is the goal and this is the code to go for. And if you are giving exams this year, take a smaller subscription plan, that will only be Plus. So 1 month, 3 months, 6 months, jo bhi aapki exam hai, us hisab se. And this is the code to use. This code will get you a 10% discount in any subscription plan that you opt for. Okay, so that is about us. That is about our plan. Now let me tell you about today's class. So I have already covered in my earlier classes a good deal of esophagus, stomach, small bowel, intestinal obstruction. Today I have some interesting questions on colon, rectum, anal canal. Okay. Mainly clinical or image oriented questions, but definitely useful questions. A couple of questions I have created today, so definitely you'll get some new matter. Some questions I have taken in my earlier classes, but they are extremely important. Okay, so I have cherry picked these. Each question you should try to make the maximum out of, and please interact and please answer the questions however possible, and don't look at other people's answers. Okay, go with your gut feeling or go with your knowledge. It's YouTube, so it's not anonymous. You can see what others are thinking, but you go for your answers. Okay. Good evening, Datesh. Datesh has been my most regular student, so I hope he does very well in whichever exam he's targeting. and all the best to you all. Okay, right. So let's start with the first one, always with the anatomy. What is this point that is marked? It's an interesting question. They have never asked this kind of a question, but this is a proper surgical anatomy question where every option has a meaning. Those who must have attended my classes earlier may have seen this. It's not a new question, but it is absolutely, absolutely important. The kind of thing, it's a crime if you don't know these things, because each of this has a surgical bearing. All my questions, I call them as surgical anatomy. This is not pure anatomy, this is surgical anatomy. Everything has a bearing. Okay, Sandeep says Griffith's point. SAP point hai kya? Griffith's point. This is colon, na, by the way. Okay, MKK says Drummond's arcade. Nurel says Sudek's point. Ira also says Griffith's point. Okay, completely mixed bag of answers. Pehle question mein itna variability, which is a little surprising. Okay. Is it Griffith? Is it Sudek? Is it an arc? Or is it an arcade? Mind you, all of these are anatomical associations of the colon. All of them. Okay, first things first, this. This, unfortunately, is Griffith's point. This is Griffith's point. Now, what is the Griffith's point? What is the bearing of this point? What do we need to know? Understand, the colon has double origin. Part of the colon comes from the midgut, and part of the colon comes from the hindgut. Okay, probably till transverse colon, somewhere 2/3, 1/3, somewhere over here, everything proximal to this is midgut, everything distal to this is hindgut. So this becomes like the boundary. What is the artery of midgut? What is the artery of hindgut? This is what you need to know. Yeah, what is the artery of midgut? What is the artery of hindgut? Anybody quickly? Basic question first, and then you will see the bearing of Griffith's point. So midgut, as you know, from D2 onwards is going to be SMA, and hindgut is going to be IMA. Okay, superior mesenteric, inferior mesenteric artery. Now understand this area, splenic flexure. This comes at the border. This is like the boundary. It is the watershed zone. It is the watershed zone. It is the zone where the blood flow of the SMA is almost over and the blood flow of the IMA is yet to begin. Yeah, small and IMA. Okay, midgut SMA. Okay, tum logon ne kuch ghuma ghuma ke likha hai, but fine, I got the point. So this area, the splenic flexure, it's the watershed zone. Neither is it getting proper blood supply from SMA, nor is the IMA yet formed. So this area, the bearing is, this area is prone to ischemia. This is called as Griffith's point or splenic flexure of the colon. So that is your answer, Griffith's point. What is Sudek's point, which Nurel marked? Surprisingly, Nurel got it wrong. What is the Sudek's point? So this is also a point. Griffith is a point, watershed zone, splenic flexure. What is Sudek's point? Ye sari charo cheeze malum honi chahiye. So as you can see in the image, this is the SMA, this is the IMA. The SMA blood flow is almost getting over here, and the IMA is not reaching till there. So this becomes the area of ischemia. Below, rectum. Below means where? What do you mean below? And what is rectum? Sigmoid colon. Okay. Better answer. What is this Sudek's point? Okay. I'll tell you. Easy way to remember. Junction of descending colon and sigmoid. Alright. It is basically the junction of rectosigmoid, where the blood flow of the descending sigmoid arteries is almost over and the superior rectal artery is beginning. This area of sigmoid colon. At this area, again, you have watershed. Again, this is prone to ischemia. but this is less commonly prone to ischemia than Griffiths. Griffiths is more commonly a site of ischemia. Pseudex is again watershed, but at the rectosigmoid or the sigmoid rectal junction or the area of sigmoid colon. Again, the blood flow gets hampered. What is Drummond's arcade? Yeah, what is this Drummond's arcade? I have a lot of interesting questions lined up, so please try to answer quickly. Most of you are attending my class not for the first time, so let's keep a little pace so that we can do justice to all the questions. I have about 6-7 questions. Sare ke sare karne aaj, kyunki fir ye mahina aur YouTube nahi hoga. At least GI I won't do on YouTube this month. I may do in special class, but not on YouTube. All colic vessels join together. Okay. Now understand, the superior mesenteric artery gives one artery which goes like this. This is your ileocolic. Then it will give an artery like this. Right colic, middle colic, left colic, sigmoid, rectal. Right. So all of these arteries are individual arteries, but when they reach the surface of the colon, you can see they are coming together throughout. They are coming together. This anastomosis, okay, this anastomosis of all these colonic arteries near the surface, this arcade that is formed, that is called Drummond's arcade. So Drummond's arcade is nothing but the common anastomosis of all the colic arteries near the surface of colon. Okay, near the surface of colon. So there is like an anastomosis. And what is this arc of Riolan? This is what I expect to be asked. This is the expected question. Arc of Riolan. What is the relevance of arc of Riolan and what is arc of Riolan? This is what I expect. Yeah. What is arc of Riolan? Ideally, all these things we should be taught in first MBBS. Clearly, we are not. And even if we are, we forget because we don't know the clinical relevance of all of these things. Yeah, what is arc of Riolan? Absolutely important. This is the question which I expect to be asked. Sir, significance. Significance of Drummond's arcade is, if I am doing a malignant resection, if I ligate the vessels at the root, the entire colon gets devitalized. On the other hand, if a small branch gets blocked distally, it can get collaterals. So it helps in collateral circulation. That is the relevance of Drummond's arcade. Collateral circulation. It's an arcade, collaterals. Arc of Riolan, so this is the SMA with the branches. This is your superior mesenteric artery. This is your inferior mesenteric artery with the branches. In some people, the SMA and the IMA have a communicating artery like this. In some people, everybody does not have it. This communicating artery between SMA and IMA is called arc of Riolan, as Datesh said. So it is a communication between superior mesenteric artery and inferior mesenteric artery. Just an offshoot, I will ask you. In the lower limb, there is a vein which communicates great saphenous vein with short saphenous vein. What is that communicating vein called? So there is a communication in the lower limb veins. This is in the lower limb veins between the GSV. We know great saphenous, short saphenous. Those are the two major superficial veins. They sometimes have a communication. What is that called? Think about it while I tell you about arc of Riolan. So arc of Riolan is SMA, IMA. What is the relevance of this? The relevance of this is if for whatever reason, the IMA gets blocked, maybe with an embolus. If I have an intact arc of Riolan, I will continue to get blood supply from the SMA via the arc of Riolan, and the IMA continues to get blood. So it's like a good thing. It will be protective of ischemia of IMA and vice versa. So if this arc is present, the collateralization will be good and the ischemia will be less. Similarly, okay, left lower limb, it is called intercommunicating vein of Giacomini. Okay, some people have answered, yeah, Ira विशा का कुछ स्पेलिंग में गड़बड़ किया है, ठीक है, नो प्रॉब्लम, यू आंसर दिस मच इट्स गुड इनफ. दिस कम्युनिकेशन इज कॉल्ड इंटर कम्युनिकेटिंग वेन ऑफ जियांगकोमिनी. दिस अगेन इज नॉट देयर इन एवरीबडी, इट इज देयर इन सम पीपल, एंड इंटर कम्युनिकेटिंग वेन बिटवीन ग्रेट एंड शॉर्ट साइफनेस वेन. ओके, डोंट जंप टू द आंसर. This is an again important. Every question today is important. I have cherry picked. These are very vast topics. What does the Goodall rule apply to? बहुत ही काम की चीज़ है. It is one of the few things which have stood the test of time. What does the Goodall rule apply to? Don't jump the gun on this. Okay. There is a little trick in the options. The options are tricky. The rule is not tricky, the options are tricky. Because when we read different books, we get confused. Har jagah alag di hai. Is it a rule to classify types of perianal abscess, drainage of perianal abscess, anatomical types of fistula, course of tract of fistula? Okay, Sandeep, Dexter, Nural, Ira, sabne bol diya D. Prediction of course of tract in fistula, and you know that is absolutely right. Is there any classification of anatomical types of fistula in NO? Is there any classification? Aisa kuch hai kya classification? Anatomical types of fistula in NO. What's that? Is there any classification or any rule on site and incision drainage of perianal abscess? And is there any classification of perianal abscess? To ye sare cheez malum hone chahiye. So what is this anatomical types of fistula in NO? What is this called? Whose classification is this? Ye to easy hai, given in all the books. Yeah, Parks classification. Must know Parks classification of anatomical types of fistula in NO. What is the incision of perianal abscess? If someone has a perianal abscess, what incision are you supposed to take? Yeah, Vishaka, Ira, Park. If I have a perianal abscess over here, what is the incision I should take on the perianal abscess? Each of these points, of course, has a bearing. So yeah, Park's classification is correct. What incision do I take on perianal abscess? So I take a cruciate incision. Please remember this, cruciate incision. Normally, when I do IND, I take a linear incision. Here I take a cruciate incision. Cruciate means cross or plus, an incision like this. Classification of types of perianal abscess, there is no name. Okay, uska kuch naam nahi hai. Now, what is the Goodall's rule? I will tell you very simply. Okay, if you read the books, it is quite, you know, difficult to understand. It's quite difficult to understand if you go by the books. I'll tell you very simply. Okay, this is lithotomy position. This is the anal verge or the anal opening. This is anterior. Okay, this is anterior posterior, and this is right and left. Now, what is the Goodall's rule? I'll tell you very simply. What does the rule say? First, you divide the perianal area into anterior and posterior halves. Okay, first you do this. Divide the anal verge into anterior and posterior halves. Now let's say I have a fistula. Okay, let's say I have a fistula. Now understand, a fistula has two parts. It has a part which opens externally, that is called external opening, and it has an internal opening. Internal opening is in the anal canal. Of course, every fistula has to have two openings, internal and external. Now let's say the external opening is in the anterior half but close by to the anal verge. Okay, close by to the anal verge. How close? Different books have given different numbers. For convenience, we say within 3 centimeters. Okay, let's say this opening, external opening, is within 3 centimeters. Har jagah pe alag alag diya hai. Kahin pe 1.5 inch diya hai, kahin pe 4 centimeters diya hai. Approximately 3 centimeters from the anal verge. If this is the external opening, then where will the internal opening be? Yeah, anybody? Where will be the internal opening? If the external opening is within 3 centimeters, That is the rule, that is the main part of the rule. Once you understand this, you will never have a problem. Yes. So if the external opening is within 3 centimeters anteriorly to the anal verge, where will be the internal opening? Okay. Any idea? Some idea? Okay. So what the rule says is the internal opening will also be anterior. So if the external opening is anterior, internal opening will be anterior. Which means how will the tract be? The tract will be a short, narrow, straight tract. On the other hand, if the external opening is more, if the external opening is beyond 3 centimeters, let's say it's over here. If the external opening is more than 3 centimeters anterior to the anal verge, then where will the internal opening be? Yeah, ERAS is anterior straight part. So if it is more than 3 centimeters, then where will the opening be? Internal opening. Yeah. Thoda lag aa raha hai mujhe tumhare answers mein. I think it's taking a little longer for my messages to reach you. So I'll try to keep the flow going. Yes, many of you have given the first part correct. Straight path, radial part, 11 o'clock along the same line. True. What if it's away? What if it's far away? More than 3 centimeters? Then the tract is not going to open anteriorly. Then the tract is going to be tortuous, curved, and then the opening will be posterior. So it will be a long, tortuous, curved, complicated tract. Okay, so again, it is predicting the opening, but it is saying that the internal opening is going to be posterior and the tract will be long and a complicated tract. It may have side branches also. This is predominantly what the Goodsall rule is. But also tell me, let's go one step ahead. When, yeah, video problem, I know you are, there is a little bit of lag. I think it's a problem with the OBS. What happens when the external opening is posterior within 3 centimeters, somewhere over here? So within 3 centimeters posterior, then where will the internal opening be? Now remember, in that case where the opening is posterior, the internal opening will also be posterior. So let's be very clear, it's very simple. I will tell you in a nutshell what the law is. What the law states, it states if external opening is within 3 centimeters anterior, internal opening will be anterior. If the external opening is more than 3 centimeters anterior, the internal opening will be posterior. And third part, if it is within 3 centimeters but posterior, internal opening will also be posterior. This is the law. External opening is predicting internal opening. So it is giving you a pathway, or it is predicting the pathway of the fistulous tract. Fine. Remember this. This is what you need to remember. This is simplified way of understanding the Goodsall's rule. Okay, I hope the video has become a little better now. I hope you guys are not having video problem now, because from my side it is going fine. There is a little lag, but that's all there should be. Nothing more than that. Okay, so that is your Goodsall's rule. Now let's move to this question. This question is the most important question of the day. And this is expected question. This is the kind of question which will come in NEET PG. So you can write it NEET 2021 question. And maybe next 1 month later, we will be discussing this question as a previous year question. Take it from me. This is the kind of question you will get, because this is on a new concept. Okay, so take a few seconds. digest what is asked and then decide what your answer is going to be. Alright, so there is a 45-year-old man. He was diagnosed to have a hepatic flexure colon cancer during a colonoscopy for anemia. So patient had anemia, bleeding in stools. You do a colonoscopy. He is young, but nowadays you get it in young patients also. So on colonoscopy, he had a colonic mass. You did the biopsy. It was adenocarcinoma of the colon. And you decided to operate. When you explored him, you saw a 3 centimeter liver metastasis, right lobe of liver metastasis. Which of the following is the most appropriate management? So I hope you have understood what the question is trying to ask you. The person has an adenocarcinoma of the hepatic flexure of colon. Okay, he has a tumor here and he has a liver metastasis, which you diagnose intraoperatively. He has a 3 centimeter liver metastasis and they are given the location also, edge of the right lobe of the liver. Okay, so he has a colorectal colonic cancer and he has a liver metastasis, which you have diagnosed intraop. Please understand, this is intraop. This question is not my own. This is from Schwartz pretest. As you can clearly see by the 5 options, मैंने नहीं बनाया ये क्वेश्चन, पर मुझे ये बहुत ही अमेजिंग लगा. Which of these is the most appropriate management? Ileostomy and further imaging? Just perform the hemicolectomy? Perform the hemicolectomy with liver mass resection? Neoadjuvant chemotherapy? Or hemicolectomy with post-operative radiation? ये सवाल आज तक पूछा नहीं है, बट 100% अगर नीट में नहीं आया ना, टेक इट इन राइटिंग, INICET में आएगा. एब्सोल्युटली कॉन्सेप्चुअल एंड दिस इज बेस्ड ऑन थिंग्स गिवन इन बेली, सो बेली में मिलेगा आपको ये. सो ईरा सेइंग न्यूएडजुवेंट कीमो, संदीप, राजवी एंड नूरल आर सेइंग हेमिकोलेक्टमी विद मेटास्टेसिस रिसेक्शन. इजंट दिस M1? डोंट यू थिंक दिस इज M1? What is the TNM stage? It is M1. Mass with liver metastasis becomes M1. So how are you thinking of curative surgery? Are you sure you should think of curative surgery? Doubt nahi aa raha? Mujhe to aa raha. Options bhi bade kathin hai. Shouldn't I just do a diverting ileostomy and maybe do something palliative? He has one metastasis. What if he has more metastasis, which I don't see, because preoperatively this liver mass was not seen. Achha. Shouldn't it be palliative chemo? So then I should have written palliative chemo. Why have I written neoadjuvant? Neoadjuvant is not palliative. The only palliative option here is diverting ileostomy. Baki sare to therapeutic lag rahe. So maybe Ira went for D because she felt this was the most appropriate option amongst the 4. Okay, I'll give you F option. Closure. Don't do anything. Plus palliative chemotherapy, radiotherapy. Chalo. I gave you that option also. F option bhi de diya. I go one step ahead of the pretest. Yes, Himendra says A, excellent. Why do you want to do a diverting ileostomy when he is not an obstruction? He just has anemia, bleeding, obstruction nahi hai. Anyways, right-sided tumors don't really obstruct. Obstruction is usually left-sided colonic masses. Napkin ring constriction, apple core. Is it distant mets? Now, Vishaka, this you have to interpret from the question. Na? Unexpected, discontinuous, 3 centimeter metastasis. Aur maine gap dikhaya dono mein. It's not a locally advanced tumor. It is a distant metastasis. और क्या है? इसलिए मैंने डायग्राम बनाया. Actually तुमको ये खुद figure out करना है. But यहाँ लिखा है ना discontinuous. So it is not a locally advanced tumor. It is a metastatic tumor. One lobe less than 3 centimeters can go excellent, excellent, excellent. That is an amazing statement which Nural has said. Excellent answer. MKK has also given a good answer, never radiotherapy. Okay, now understand what happens here and how you rule out the options. If you don't know the answer, you can definitely rule out the options. Ileostomy is not going to be done since the person is not obstructed. Okay, he is not having intestinal obstruction. Why will I do the ileostomy? For what? Right hemicolectomy cannot be the answer because I cannot just remove this tumor. I have to do something for this. That option goes. Closure with palliative chemotherapy could be one option, which is not given there. Unfortunately for me, lucky for you. Understand adenocarcinomas. This is an adenocarcinoma, hepatoma. Radiation, not very useful. Three options straight away go out. Ye to option sochna hi nahi hai. Post-op radiation normally adenocarcinoma mein nahi help karta hai. Normally, thode bahut mein karta hai. Rectal cancer mein, yes, you give radiation. Esophageal cancer is a squamous cell carcinoma. So radiotherapy, adenocarcinoma does not help much. Those are chemosensitive. So really speaking, your doubt should have been between these two. Now understand, in today's day and age, one or two liver metastases from colorectal cancers is not M1. Okay, so in today's day and age, liver metastasis from colorectal cancer is not M1. It can be resected at the same time. So the best answer here would be right hemicolectomy for the tumor and local resection, or what you will call as wide local excision of liver metastasis. What is this called? Wide local excision of metastasis. What is it called? What is the surgical name of this procedure? Where I only remove the metastasis with a circumferential margin. What is this called? There is a surgical name for this. So it's actually naam hota hai. What is it called? There is a name for this. Scientific name. When I only remove the metastasis. So I'm not doing hepatectomy. I'm doing a wide excision. What would you call this? Ever heard of this term? It is called metastatectomy. Metastatectomy. So nowadays, for liver metastasis from colorectal cancers, if it's one or two chote metastasis, you can do a metastatectomy. Means wide local excision of the metastasis. In which other organ do you do metastatectomy? From colorectal cancers. Yeah. In which other organ? Sir, but it's T4. Why are you saying it's T4? Kahan di hai T4? T4 kahan di hai? Hepatic flexure colon cancer. That's all. Yeah. Metastatectomy. Two people have, I don't know whether you have repeated it or you got it from me. In which other organ do you do metastatectomy from colorectal cancer? One is liver, which is the other cancer where if there are one or two mets, you can actually excise the mets. You don't take it as M1. Ek hai liver, dusra kaun si organ hai? Which is the second organ. Malum hi hona chahiye. Yeah. Any other organ where you do metastatectomy? Any idea? Ever heard? Yes, Vishaka. I expect you to answer Vishaka Nurel. The stars of the show. No idea. Yes, the other place is lung. So even if there are pulmonary metastasis, they can be removed. Now the golden question. How do I decide whether it is going to be excisable or not? Means when do I decide whether I should do metastatectomy or no? It's too much. It's a very heavy load. Yeah, Sandeep, that's right. Answer was lung. So what is the defining criteria to say, yeah, itna tumor hai, toh metastatectomy kar sakte. Itna hai toh kar sakte hai, itna hai toh nahi kar sakte. What decides how much of a metastasis can be excised? For liver, I'm saying. Yeah, दिस इज अ गोल्डन क्वेश्चन, ये अगर आपको मालूम है तो नथिंग लाइक इट, गोल्डन, दिस इज पीस ऑफ गोल्ड एंड इट्स देयर इन बेली, माइंड यू दिस क्वेश्चन दैट आई फ्रेम्ड आई रेड इट इन बेली, सो आई एम आस्किंग यू, कितने ट्यूमर्स में निकाल सकता हूँ? Is it that I can remove if it's only in one lobe or if they are up to 3 centimeters as Nural was saying? Is it so? Or it's something else? Again, is there any criteria? Let's spice, cook up the pot a little bit more. Size. What size? Think before you give the answer, and answer is in Bailey. In Bailey, you know, liver, which is such a huge topic, there are only 18 pages. Only 18 pages, it's a shame. Number of mets confined to one lobe or not, and size of mets. Acha. So what if there are 3 mets and each met is up to 3 centimeters? You may have heard of this somewhere. Then can I do metastatectomy? Or no, it's too much. Is it too much then? Or no, nikal do. One is in the left lobe, one is in the right lobe, one is somewhere in the middle. There are 3 tumors in different lobes or different segments. Each tumor is less than 3 centimeters. Can I do metastatectomy? Invasion of vessels surrounding, obviously, goes without saying. If it is infiltrating portal vein or hepatic artery or IVC, I am not going to excise it. That holds true for any hepatic tumor. Here I am talking about metastasis. Which metastasis can be excised? You say number, location. I have given you this scenario. 3 mets, each less than 3 centimeters. Can I remove each of the metastases? And I give you the location also. So let me see what Nural and Ira say now. See, I always tell my students that your life is as difficult as you make it. You want to make it difficult, you can make it miserable. You want to make it simple, you listen to what I say and keep it simple. Don't run behind the millions of things that we do. Okay, let's try to keep our life simple. It's very easy. There is a criteria. Ye jo main bata raha hu na, this is not the criteria. Okay, this is not the criteria. This criteria was applicable to something else. Anybody knows what this criteria is? Minimum liver reserve should be maintained, right? It is based on that only. You are absolutely right. First, you tell me this 3 mets, each less than 3 centimeter is which criteria? First, tell me that. Nural, this I have discussed recently only in high yield and surgery class. I have discussed this. 3 mets, 3, less than 3 in number. What criteria is that? Each tumor less than 4.5 centimeters, single tumor, or 3 tumors each less than 3 centimeters. This is which criteria? Papre! It's called Milan criteria. But remember, Milan criteria is not for liver mets. It is for someone who has HCC. This is not HCC, this is metastasis. Who has HCC plus cirrhosis. So let us not get confused with this. Okay, that is Milan criteria. But that is an HCC with cirrhosis. Which patients can undergo liver transplant? That is the criteria. This is a different criteria. This is talking about metastasis from a colorectal cancer. This criteria is very easy. This criteria says it doesn't matter how many mets are there. Okay, it doesn't matter how many mets, number, size. What matters is when I do an excision, what is the amount of normal liver that will be left behind, what is called as FLR, future liver remnant or functional liver residue. The FLR or the future liver remnant should be more than 25%. This is the criteria. So these are two different criteria. This criteria is talking about metastasis. So for colorectal metastasis to the liver, I can excise as many tumors as long as the normal left behind liver has a volume of more than 25%. Bus. The rest of the liver will regenerate. But this is for metastasis, this is not for hepatoma. For hepatoma, the criteria is Milan criteria, which is with cirrhosis. See, understand, people who get hepatoma also have cirrhosis. In them, future liver residue does not matter because that 25% left behind liver is not normal liver, it is cirrhosis liver. तो वो काफी नहीं होगा. They need more liver left behind. So for them it is Milan criteria. This is for if I have a colonic cancer, my liver is not going to be cirrhosed. At least should not be. So if I have 25% normal liver left behind, the rest can be excised with the tumors. This is the indication and criteria for metastatectomy as per Bailey. Don't read oncosurgery books for this. Keep it simple. You read books like DeVita, which will give you more intricate knowledge. We don't need that. Okay, we don't need that. Now I will spice it up a little bit more. Let's take all of this out. Same question. I want to see how you guys think. Same question. Okay. I only change one thing here. All right. So patient has this hepatic flexure colon cancer for anemia requiring transfusions. Forget this upon exploration. Remove this part. Let's put it as when I do say a CT abdomen, I do a CECT, I see an unexpected 3 cm liver metastasis. Now tell me the next step. So this is a different case. Here the liver met is not identified intraoperatively. I did a CT and on CT I saw the liver met. 3 cm liver metastasis. And Vishaka, before you ask me, this is a liver metastasis. But I have diagnosed this pre-op. Not intra-op. I have diagnosed this pre-op. What is the most appropriate management of this patient? Now tell me the answer. Pre-operatively diagnosed liver metastasis, single metastasis, 3 cm. What will you do? Golden question. Both of these questions, I have just twisted them on one front. Baki sara same hai. You have to get the answer. Same question hai. Ek mein I diagnose is intraop, which we discussed. So I did, this is the intraop question. Let's say I see the liver met preoperatively. Am I going to do the same thing? Right hemicol with local resection of metastasis? Or am I now going to do something else? Now is my treatment going to change? Palliative. Achha, intra-op mila to curative. Aur pre-op mila to palliative. Haan, Ira? Aapko patient bolega, phir aapne mera CT scan kyun kiya? Isse achha to aap mujhe cure kar dete. CT scan ki wajah se aapne mujhe palliation bata diya. Neoadjuvant. Or do the same thing. Can't I do again? Because now to on CT I will know na, future liver remnant kitna bachega. So can't I do the same thing, hemicolectomy with metastatectomy? Yeah. Explore origin of mets means what? What does explore origin of metastasis mean? I don't understand that. Could you elaborate that point? What does that mean? Explore origin of metastasis. Yeah, I'm curious to see what you guys think now. Palliation, neoadjuvant, I don't know what is the meaning of explore origin of metastasis. But I hope you have gotten the question. Preoperative liver metastasis, what are you going to do? And please don't make the patient feel miserable for having a liver metastasis, because nowadays colorectal tumors with liver mets are not inoperable. If they are one or two mets, liver can be salvaged, good enough. Do chemo to decrease the size. Okay, absolutely right. So understand, if it's pre-op, I have actually already written over here, if pre-op, you will give neoadjuvant chemotherapy. Downstage it and then do the surgery. So you do the hemicolectomy, and if there is any liver met which still remains, then you can do metastatectomy. The only difference here is if I know beforehand, then I start with neoadjuvant chemotherapy. That's the only difference. If intra-op, I told you, can resect if FLR is more than 25%. Okay, nowadays, even if the FLR is less than 25%, you do this procedure. It's called ALPS. You don't need to know the details. You do what is called as ALPS. It is called associated liver partition. ये याद रहा तो ठीक है, अदरवाइज यू डोंट हैव टू वरी अबाउट इट. पोर्टल वेन लाइगेशन एंड स्टेज्ड हेपेटेक्टमी, जस्ट रिमेंबर द नेम, यू डोंट नीड टू नो द डिटेल्स ऑफ दिस. दिस कैन हेल्प यू इफ माई एफ एल आर इज लेस देन 25%. सो वॉट आई डू इज आई लाइगेट द पोर्टल वेन ऑन वन साइड, ओके, द साइड ऑफ द ट्यूमर, दैट साइड का पोर्टल वेन आई लाइगेट. सो वॉट विल हैपन, द नॉर्मल साइड, द नॉर्मल हाफ ऑफ द लिवर विल अंडर गो अ कॉम्पनसेटरी हाइपरट्रॉफी. सो इफ आई हैव टू थ्री मेटास्टेसिस इन द राइट लोब विच आई कांट एक्साइज, ओके, बिकॉज द लेफ्ट लोब इज वेरी स्मॉल. सो वॉट आई डू, आई एम्बोलाइज द राइट पोर्टल वेन. सो वॉट हैपन, द लेफ्ट लोब विल स्टार्ट हाइपरट्रॉफी बिकॉज लिवर अंडर गोज हाइपरट्रॉफी, एंड देन आई डू द हेपेटेक्टमी. सो नाउ वेन आई हैव डन द हेपेटेक्टमी, I have a more than 25% FLR. This is called ALPS procedure. इससे ज़्यादा जानने की ज़रूरत नहीं है. All of these lines are in Bailey. Mind you, मैंने कोई high fund ना ऑन्को सर्जरी बुक से नहीं लिया है, मैंने सब बेली से निकाला. ओके, लिवर मेट्स रिसेक्शन ओनली फॉर सी आर सी और एनी अदर कैंसर मेट्स, एज ऑफ नाउ ओनली फॉर सी आर सी, बट फॉर अदर जी आई कैंसर ऑल्सो, स्टमक ऑल्सो, बट सी आर सी एंड स्टमक आर द मोस्ट कॉमन जी आई कैंसर्स विच हैव लिवर मेट्स. बाकी सारे कैंसर्स का लिवर मेट्स नहीं होता नॉर्मली, किडनी, ब्लैडर, दे ऑल गो टू लंग्स और वट एवर. लिवर मेट्स इज फ्रॉम जी आई कैंसर, जी आई इज ओनली स्टमक एंड कोलोरेक्टल, स्मॉल बाउल में तो नॉर्मली कैंसर होता नहीं है. सो इट्स डिफाइंड प्राइमरीली फॉर कोलोरेक्टल कैंसर मेट्स, ओके, इट्स नॉट गोइंग टू बी आस्क्ड फॉर एनी अदर मेट्स. ओके, दिस इज अ टॉपिक विच डिजर्व स्पेशल मेंशन. ऑल ऑफ दीज आर लिमिटेशन ऑफ कैप्सूल एंडोस्कोपी, except it deserves a little mention because it's absolutely important. Today all questions are important. You need to know what is capsule endoscopy and which of these is not a limitation of capsule endoscopy. TACE, transarterial chemoembolization. No, this is done surgically, portal vein embolization. It's portal vein ligation, it's not embolization. And portal vein, you are saying TACE. TACE is arterial, that is hepatic artery embolization. Those are different. Here I am surgically ligating the portal vein. So it's staged hepatectomy. So I do two surgeries. Don't worry about it. It's better you know TACE, TAR, TAE, than you know ALPS. ALPS puchna mushkil hai, but TACE puchenge. So don't go in that territory. Better not. Yeah. सो कैप्सूल एंडोस्कोपी के ये सारे लिमिटेशन है एक्सेप्ट दी. ये तो इजी क्वेश्चन है, ये तो आना चाहिए. पर कैप्सूल एंडोस्कोपी इज व्हाट आई वांट टू डिस्कस, दैट्स व्हाई आई पुट दिस क्वेश्चन. रिक्वायर्स एनेस्थीसिया, कैनॉट परफॉर्म एनी इंटरवेंशन, कैनॉट लोकलाइज एग्जैक्ट साइट, कैनॉट बी यूज इन सस्पेक्टेड स्ट्रक्चर्स. ऑफकोर्स इट डज नॉट रिक्वायर एनी एनेस्थीसिया. ऑल एंडोस्कोपीज यूजली रिक्वायर सम काइंड ऑफ एनेस्थीसिया. कैप्सूल एंडोस्कोपी इज अ यूनिक काइंड ऑफ एंडोस्कोपी वेयर ऑल यू हैव टू डू इज यू स्वॉलो दिस कैप्सूल. इट्स अ बिग कैप्सूल, यू कैन सी इट्स ऑलमोस्ट 2.5 सेंटीमीटर्स, मतलब बड़ी गोली है. इट्स लाइक हैविंग थ्री टैबलेट्स, थ्री बिग टैबलेट्स. ओके, दिस कैप्सूल हैज अ लॉट ऑफ पार्ट्स. ओके, इट हैज अ कैमरा इन साइड, सो देर इज अ कैमरा, देर इज अ लाइट सोर्स, देर इज अ रिकॉर्डिंग मटीरियल विच विल प्रोसेस. सो ऑल दीज थिंग्स आर देर, देर इज समथिंग दैट विल टेक फोटोग्राफ्स. सो देर आर स्मॉल 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 कंपोनेंट्स, लाइट कंपोनेंट, बिकॉज अंदर इल्यूमिनेशन चाहिए. इट हैज अ कैमरा, इट हैज अ रिकॉर्डर, इट हैज अ ट्रांसमीटर. ओके, सो देर आर स्मॉल स्मॉल पार्ट, इट हैज अ बैटरी, विच आर ऑल अ कंपोनेंट ऑफ दिस कैप्सूल. ही स्वॉलोज द कैप्सूल एंड ही वेयर्स अ रिकॉर्डिंग डिवाइस. सो वॉट हैपन्स इज एज द कैप्सूल गोज इन हिज जी आई ट्रैक्ट, द कैप्सूल स्टार्ट्स टेकिंग फोटोग्राफ्स. Those photographs are recorded on the recorder that he wears. So he is doing his normal things, he is living his life. But the capsule while it is inside is taking these photos and putting it on the recording device. And after a few days, he will notice that he has passed off the capsule. Okay, he should know that he has passed off the capsule in his stools. He has to pass it within 3 to 5 days. Then this recording device, he gives it to the technician. The technician will get the images and then the surgeon or the gastroenterologist will see the images, taken at different different parts in the small bowel. So basically poor intestine ka wo capsule photo leta andar se, it keeps taking multiple photos. So you see images. Of course you cannot take biopsy. Of course, which part of the small bowel has the problem, can't say for sure, because it's all inside, there is no correlation from outside. But definitely it can image the entire bowel. It can image the entire bowel, which conventional endoscopes cannot. It's difficult. Small bowel is between 3 to 8 meters. No endoscope will go through 3 to 8 meters. If I have 8 meters of small bowel, I cannot do its endoscopy. It's very difficult, right? But the capsule will do everything. It will image the entire small bowel. Any indication? Here, contraindication. And what is the main indication for capsule endoscopy? Just tell me one indication for capsule endoscopy. It's like Chandrayaan mission or rover. Yeah, no, but they can, you know, takes the samples, na? Those satellites, if they land on the moon or Mars, they can take the samples. This fellow cannot take any sample. He's benign. So he's not going to do anything except for just see and come back. Wo log to sample le sakte hain. Tell me the main indication for capsule endoscopy. Answer is in 3 words. Answer is in 3 words. In which patient do I do capsule endoscopy? Mainly ek indication. Yeah. Any idea? In whom do I do capsule endoscopy? In whom do I need to do imaging of the small bowel from inside? So answer is going to be only one. It's called obscure GI bleed. It's called obscure GI bleed. Absolutely right, Sandeep. Excellent answer. Obscure GI bleed. The word obscure means patient says that mere sandas mein khoon jata hai. Okay, it's not GI bleed, it's obscure GI bleed, it's definitely not carcinoid. He says sandas mein khoon jata hai. Okay, sandas mein khoon jana means what? Either there is a problem, depends on what kind of blood it is. Either it's a cancer in the stomach, cancer, an ulcer in the stomach, some problem in the colon. So you do upper GI endoscopy. Stomach is fine, duodenum is fine. You do colonoscopy. Colon is absolutely fine. So he's having GI bleed, but there is no source seen on upper GI and colonoscopy. This means he has obscure GI bleed, where you cannot identify the site on endoscopy. Okay, this is the only place where you will suspect maybe the bleeding is in the small bowel. Maybe small bowel is the source, so you may want to do this. So understand, this will not show where exactly the bleeding is. It will only show that yes, maybe there is a ulcer in the small bowel, some inflammation in the small bowel, which is the cause of the bleeding. That is the only thing. Okay, all right. This image is there in Bailey. Absolutely important image, must know image, 100% image. What is this image? 100% neat PG like question. This is, it's newly introduced in Bailey. What procedure is this? Is it a hemorrhoidopexy? Is it a star? Is it a TATME or is it a waft? Sare full form to at least malum hone chahiye. Full form at least malum hone chahiye. Bhale procedure nahi pata ho. Star is called stapled transanal rectal resection. Stapled transanal rectal resection. TATME is called transanal TME, you know, total mesorectal excision. Total mesorectal excision, jo rectal cancer mein karte hain, TME bolte hain usko. And waft, it's called video assisted anal fistula tract excision. At least the full forms you should know. Acha, so Ira, this is a stapler. You change the answer from C to A. Sandeep ka dekke. This is a stapler. This is a stapled hemorrhoidopexy. Aise hoti hai stapler. This is a stapler. Does it look like a stapler? What is happening over here? There is a camera. There are some instruments, and I am going and doing something over here. What am I doing over here? What is this going on? What is this going on? So I have some endoscopic instruments which I've got inside the anal canal, and I'm doing something over here in front of the sacrum. What is this? Unfortunately, no, it's not stapled amyroidopexy. This is TATME, transanal total mesorectal excision. What is TME? TME means when I remove the mesorectum, which is behind the rectum, as a part of resection of C rectum. So when I have a C rectum, I will resect the rectum. Depending on how big it is, I take an oncosurgical margin along with the mesorectum. Mesorectum is basically the lymphatics and the lymph nodes of the rectum. That is called TME. TATME is transanal. Either you do transanal if it's a small tumor, or you may do open surgery, or you may do laparoscopic surgery. So this is TATME. Alright, waft ye nahi puchenge aapko. Stapled amyroidopexy, I'll show you. This you need to know. Ye dusri kaam ki image hai. But you need to be able to identify a stapler. What stapler I use? I use what is called as a circular stapler. I have shown you many times a circular stapler. How it looks. It has two parts. This is the main stapler gun, and this, what is this called? The part which goes inside, the part of the stapler which helps you identify it's a circular stapler. What is this called? Bahut baar dikhaya maine. Bolna nahi ke pata nahi kya hai. What is this called? This part of the circular stapler. It looks like this. Ye malum hona chahiye. Ye maine bahut baar bataya. This is called, yeah, annual of the stapler. So what I do here, I pass the anvil across the hemorrhoids and I staple the hemorrhoid mass. So the hemorrhoid mass gets caught in the stapling device. That is why it's called stapled hemorrhoidopexy. It is nothing but stapling of the pile mass with the help of this circular stapler device. Fine. Ye image malum honi chahiye. Ye bhi Bailey mein diya hai. Isme to Bailey mein iska pura procedure describe kiya. Stapled amyroidopexy looks same. How does it look the same? You look at this. Look at the circular stapler with the anvil. You look at this. Ye kaun sa circular stapler hai? Ye to laparoscopic instruments hai. And you, most important, you see where it is going na? It is going in the mesorectum. It's not in the anal canal. It's so far high up. It's going in the mesorectum. Anal canal is over here, right at the edge. This is your anal canal. All this is rectum. Okay, by no scope of imagination are they the same, right? Circular stapler you will identify with this. This is the anvil of the stapler. Ye kabhi nahi bhulna. It looks like this. There is a very big device. I have shown it many times. Badi si aisi gun hoti hai, stapler gun. One part is like this. The other part which gets disconnected, it's a metal anvil. So whatever I am going to staple, I will put it in between the anvil and the stapling device, and I fire the stapler. Okay, that is your circular stapler.